Okay, for this video, start natin yung review natin sa machine design, starting sa fundamental concept, simple stresses. Okay, so when we say stress, it is the unit strength of material. Okay, unit strength, it is simply the force per unit area. So mathematically, force per unit area is force divided by area, wherein F is force. May unit na Newton sa SI, pound force sa English. At sa area naman, may unit na square millimeter. Sa English ay square inches. Okay? So, such that pag dinivide mo, yung magnitude ng force divided by the area in millimeters, ang unit niyan sa stress ay mega pascal. Then sa English naman, pound force per square inches ay PSI. Kaya lang, take note, itong definition na to na force over area is the average stress considering no stress concentration. Okay, hindi yan yung total stress dun sa body. Okay, so para mas accurate yung definition, let us define stress in terms of differential force and differential area. Wherein considering, for example, meron kang differential area, small area. So, then may applied force, differential force. So, yung total stress is the, when you divide differential force divided by differential area. Okay. Now, let us proceed sa types ng stresses. Okay, ano na yun yung types ng simple stresses? Okay, una, yung tinatawag na normal stress. Okay, so when we say normal stress, it is the average stress. Okay, the average stress developed by a force perpendicular to the area. So, yun yung keyword, perpendicular sa area. So, we have this symbol, sigma n, sub n, equal to the normal force divided by the perpendicular area. Okay, merong two types ng normal stress. So, we have two types. Unang type, yung tinatawag na tensile stress. So, when you say tensile stress, it is the average normal stress dahil type nga siya na under siya ng normal stress due to normal force or perpendicular force in outward direction. So, keyword is outward direction. Example, cables. Okay? So, we have this formula, tensile stress is equal to tensile force or the force in outward direction, normal force in outward direction, divided by the perpendicular area dun sa force. Then, second type ng normal stress ay yung tinatawag na compressive stress. So, kung meron kang outward force, meron ka ring inward force. So, kung yung stress na madedevelop, yun yung tinatawag na compressive stress or simply the average normal stress due to normal or perpendicular force in inward direction. So, meron tayong formula. Compressive stress is equal to compressive force, FC, divided by the perpendicular area dun sa force. Okay, then another type ng simple stress, yung tinatawag na shear stress. Okay, pag sinabing shear stress, it is the average stress developed by a force parallel to the area. Okay, keyword, we have this keyword, parallel area. Okay, sa board exam, mahalaga yung mga keyword na yan dahil may mga tanong na elements. So, mahalaga alam niyo yung mga keyword sa bawat terms or elements. Okay, so shear stress is simply, so symbol ng shear stress ay tau. So, shear stress tau is equal to shear force, divided by shear area. So, other symbol ng shear force ay B. Okay? So, shear force over shear area. Okay, another type. Okay, application muna. Ano yung mga application ng shear stress? So, apply natin. So, for unang sample, pinaka-basic yung sa rivets or bolts. For example, meron tayong bolts na may diameter D. So, yung corresponding shear stress niya, for example, yung applied force mo is in this direction. So, meron kang shear force in this direction. Shear area niya is the area parallel dun sa force, which is yung cross-sectional ng bolt, which is equal to area ng circle, pi over 4 diameter square. So, okay, alam natin yan. Then, another example is punching a hole. So, example, we have this plate na gusto mong butasin in circular form. Ano yung magiging corresponding shear area? So, pag inimagine nyo, pag nag-punch ka ng hole, parang ang magiging itsura, halimbawa, yung coin. Okay, sa coin, ano yung corresponding shear area niya? Yung shear area niya ay yung area ng gilid. So, pag niroll nyo yung coin, makaka-form ka ng rectangle na mayroong dimension na circumference ng coin, pi d, by thickness. So, shear area is simply pi dt. Okay? Then, pangatlo, sa shear stress is cutting a plate. For example, we have this plate. So, pag kinat sa dalawa, so yung corresponding shear area niya is simply the length of cut, take note, length of cut times the thickness. But, inipasize ko yung length of cut kasi for example, yung plate mo, halimbawa, kinat ng hindi straight. For example, yung pagkakakat sa kanya is ganito. So, yung magiging corresponding length of cut niyan, syempre, yung length nung kinat sa kanya, ito. So, yan yung L. Okay? So, times the thickness. So, yun yung sa cutting ng plate. Then, pangatlong type ng simple stresses is yung tinatawag na torsional stress or torsional shear stress. So, it is simply the shear stress developed in a body under torsion. So, under na torsion or if you have this load torque due to applied torque. So, most common example, syempre, shaft. Okay, formula. So, shear stress is derived. Formula is simply the torque, applied torque, times the distance from the axis divided by the polar moment J. Okay? So, we're in. So, lagyan natin ng unit. Torque. Unit sa SI is Newton millimeters. Sa English naman ay inch pound force. Okay? Then, yung C is the distance from the axis. May unit sa SI na millimeters. Sa English naman ay inches. And then, yung polar moment J, ang unit niyan ay millimeter raised to 4. Sa English naman ay inches raised to 4. Such that, yung magiging unit ng shear stress mo, tau. So, pag dinivide mo, cancel yung square, matitira, Newton per square millimeter, mega Pascal. Sa English naman, ganun din, PSI. Okay, so, polar moment for solid shaft is simply pi over 32 diameter, capital D natin, diameter raised to 4. Okay, so we're in C. So, saan mangyayari yung maximum shear stress? So, halimbawa, ito yung cross-section. Okay? So, from this formula, you can see na yung shear stress ay directly proportional sa distance C. Meaning to say, habang lumalayo doon sa axis, mas lumalaki yung shear stress. Ibig sabihin, mangyayari yung maximum shear stress sa outer fiber. So, sa pinakamalayo sa axis. Ito yun. Okay? So, habang lumalayo ka sa axis, lalong lumalaki yung shear stress. So, mangyayari yung maximum shear stress at C equal to the radius. Okay? So, ito yun. So, pag yung C mo equal to radius, dun mangyayari yung maximum shear stress. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, yung maximum shear stress for solid shaft is simply T times the distance kung saan mangyayari yung maximum shear stress equal to R, which is equal to half ng diameter. So, ibig sabihin, D over 2 divided by polar moment ng solid circular is simply pi over 32 d raised to 4. So simplify, ibig sabihin for solid shaft, maximum shear stress is simply, simplify natin, mangyayari dyan ay 16 t pi diameter raised to, raised to 3 na lang. Okay, so yan yung maximum shear stress sa solid shaft. Okay, ganun din for hollow shaft. For hollow shaft. Okay, so we have this for hollow shaft. Yung polar moment J niya is given by pi over 4 outside raised to 4 minus inside diameter raised to 4. So, pag sinubstitute natin, ganun din. So, ang maximum shear stress for hollow cross-section will be T times diameter outside over 2, dahil dun mangyayari yung maximum shear stress, divided by pi over 32 times D raised to 4 minus inside raised to 4. Or, so maximum shear stress for hollow will be 16t times the outside diameter divided by pi times the outside raised to 4 minus inside raised to 4. So ito yung maximum shear stress for hollow shaft. Okay, so then the next type of simple stress ay yung tinatawag na bearing stress. So basically, it is the contact pressure between separate bodies. So, or it is the stress developed by a force to the projected area. Okay, keyword, projected area. Basically, ito yung surface type ng compressive stress. Application, most common application ay journal bearing. So for example, we have this journal bearing. So such that we have this shaft, ito. Ito yung shaft natin. Ito yung journal bearing natin. Journal bearing. Okay, so ano yung corresponding bearing stress? So yung magiging corresponding bearing stress niya, so sabi natin, by definition, force by projected area. So sa case natin, ano yung projected area? So if you have this load dun sa shaft, so yung corresponding projected area niya is ito. So pag pinroject ko yung shaft doon sa bearing, ito yung magiging corresponding projected area. Okay? Length ng bearing L times the diameter. So, yun yung projected or bearing area. So, length times diameter. So, formula ng bearing stress, sigma sub B is equal to the load F divided by load F divided by the bearing area for bearing or journal bearing, which is equal to L times D. Okay? Then, the last type ng simple stress ay yung tinatawag na bending or flexural stress. When you say bending or flexural stress, ito yung stress developed by the bending moment. So, keyword, bending moment. So, pag meron kang bending moment, yung corresponding stress na madidevelop, ang tawag doon bending or flexural stress. Derived formula ng flexural stress is equal to MC over I. Where M, okay, so where M is the moment or bending moment. May unit sa SI na Newton millimeters. Okay, sa English naman, okay, inch pound force. Then C is the distance of the fiber from the neutral axis. So we have this millimeters. Sa English naman, inches. Then I is the moment of inertia. Unit sa SI ay millimeter raised to 4. Sa English naman, inches raised to 4. So pwede nyo i-check yung relation ng moment of inertia at polar moment of inertia, dinerive natin or pinrove natin sa mga naunang video ko. Okay, so wherein yung flexural or bending stress ay ganun, Newton per square millimeter, which is pinroob natin mega Pascal, sa English ay PSI. Okay, for example, we have this beam, rectangular beam. So, simply supported. Then we have this neutral axis na sa gitna. Then for example, we have this load F. So, mangyayari, exaggerated, magkakaroon ka ng bending. Exaggerated na lang. Okay? Magkakaroon ng bending. Okay. Yung corresponding stress na madidevelop is known as bending or flexural stress. Okay, sa bending, ang nangyayari, ganito. Okay, for example, sa case natin, andito yung load sa taas. Okay, mangyayari, yung nasa, meron kang neutral axis. Okay, neutral axis. Then, yung nasa taas, ang mangyayari, mag-compression. Right? Magko-compress yung mga fiber dito. Then, sa baba naman, tension. Okay? So, tension yung sa baba, compression yung sa taas, sa case ng ganitong loading. Okay, so, kaya mangyayari, meron kang dalawang value ng flexural stress. Flexural stress compression, which is equal to bending moment over I, yung distance mo is yung distance nung compressed fiber. Ito yun. Okay? Then, yung bendings or flexural stress naman sa tensile side is bending moment times yung distance or ng fiber in sa tensile side divided by moment of inertia. Okay? So, meron kang dalawang value ng bending stress. Okay.